Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for joining in. So today I want to show you how my family and I transformed this room into a more elegant space for my mother's surprise 75th birthday party. And in this video, I'm going to show you how my husband and I created a 30 feet backdrop made from PVC piping. And we did it by doing 3 10 feet sections using this piping. So if you want to know how we made these, why don't you come on in and let me show you how we transform this room into this beautiful, elegant space. For each 10 feet section, we used 5 PVC pipes, which all started out at 10 feet, but we cut them down to different sizes. For the cutter, we used a hacksaw, but you could use a PVC pipe cutter or a Dremel tool. And for our connectors, we use a 4-way, and we use only one of these 4-way connectors. We found most of the connectors at the local hardware store, except for this 5-way connector here. We had to order off of Amazon. I will put the link in the description box, because for some reason our hardware stores in the area did not carry it. Now the T connector, we use 3 of those. And for the 90 degree or the elbow connector, we used 14 of those. And you will see here, this is a 6-inch piece that we cut a PVC piping to use, and you're gonna need 12 of those per 10 feet section. So first, we started by cutting 3 of the 10 feet PVC pipes down to 8 feet. So basically we took 2 feet off of 3 of the 10 feet poles. The one thing to keep in mind in this video, we are showing you how we made a 10 feet section. So if you want to do the 30 feet, you would have to connect 3 of these sections together. Once we finish cutting the 2 feet off of each PVC pipe, we use those pieces to create the 6-inch pieces that I showed you in the beginning of this video. So basically, when you're cutting the 10 feet pipe down to 8 feet, the extra 2 feet, you're going to use those to cut 6 inches out. So this is what he's doing here. My husband is measuring each spot. So he's measuring 6 inches along this 2 feet piece of piping. And there should be 4 sections to cut out. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And so we're going to cut those. And after we did that, this is what you have to make the feet. And that 5-way connector is where you would connect them. Now you'll see that we still have 10 feet piping that we haven't touched yet. And then these are the 8 feet pipe that we cut off of the camera. We didn't record that, but we cut those 3 8-foot pipes in half, making 4 feet piping. So we have 6 4 feet piping and 2 10-foot piping at this point. The next step is to cut 4 feet off of the last 2 10-foot pipes, creating 6 feet piping. And once it's assembled, you will see why we did it this way. Once we finished this cut, then we started to connect all of the piping together with the connectors. And you'll see how we did it. We showed you step by step how we connect each piece together. Basically, this is one of the feet you would need for this 10-foot section, and you're gonna need 3 of these too. And this is where you would make it stand. This is how it will stand up. Now that we've cut all the pieces and assembled the feet, this is just a layout of what it looks like before we connect it together. So I wanted you to kind of see what the layout would look like before it's connected together. Basically, this is how the connectors are going to connect each piping. Now, if you're going to do a connect, add it another 10 feet in this corner and on this end, instead of the elbow and this 3-way connector, you're gonna need a 3-way at the top, and then on the side you're gonna need 4-way there. Like this 4-way, you're gonna need it on the end to connect the next section. In this video, I was just showing how we did 1 10-foot section. Now this is my husband just assembling it together now. And the one thing you may need is a rubber mallet to actually make sure that when you connect them that they will stay connected so it won't tumble over or fall over, especially after you put the your curtains or whatever you're putting on here. Now this is it completed. I just put a sample of my curtains on there so you can see how it's done. And you just need to cover the poles or the PVC piping that you don't want to be seen. Just put enough curtain and gather them together so it can cover the pipe. Well guys, that is it for this video, but I will say that doing this particular backdrop was the better route for us and for the occasion and the room that we needed it for. We checked Amazon for backdrops, but the taller and the wider ones, like what we need, they were a lot more expensive, and it was cheaper for us to go this route. The taller ones and the wider ones on Amazon starts, I believe, at $150 and can go all the way up to $300, and we needed at least 2 to 3 of those. So it was a lot less expensive to do this backdrop. And I wanna thank my husband for helping me with this, doing this backdrop, as well as doing the video. So my family and I, we really enjoyed everything we did to surprise my mother. She was very surprised, and we were so happy that everything came out the way it did. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you can receive future notifications on my upcoming videos. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.